Knowest thou not this of old, since man was placed upon earth, that the triumphing of the wicked is short? And it's talking about to you elites, to you white people who rule the world, who put the blacks, slaves, Native Americans into slavery and took all their wealth and all, you know, their heritage, you know. It says the triumphing of the wicked is short, and it's coming to an end because during the Third World War. Because that's when Yahweh Shah gonna return and redeem his people. It says, and the joy of the hypocrite but for a moment, though his excellency mount up to the heavens, and his head reach unto the clouds, or some by the satellites, yet he shall perish forever like his own dung. They which have seen him shall say, where is he? And ultimately the white man gonna be destroyed after Yahweh Shah's return, and we put him into slavery for 1,000 years. It says, he shall fly away as a dream, and shall not be found. Yea, he shall be chased away as a vision of the night. I'm going to jump to verse 18. It says, that which he labored for shall he restore, and shall not swallow down. Right, all that he labored for, his new world order, him taking all our wealth, our heritage, our lands, all that's going to be restored back to us. To the blacks, Latins, Native Americans, which are the Israelites. It says, according to his substance shall the restitution be, and he shall not rejoice therein, because he hath oppressed and hath forsaken the poor, the Israelites, because he hath violently taken away in the house which he buildeth not, and that's talking about the land. They took the North American Indians' land, they took the land of Israel. Surely he shall not feel quietness in his belly. He shall not save that which he desired. Right, because all the nations are starting to come against him. All the people of the world are starting to come against him. There shall none of his meat be left. Therefore shall no man look for his goods. And the fullness of his sufficiency shall he be in straits. Right, so you elites who are trying to bring in this new world order, the Lord not having that. Sorry. It says, surely he shall not feel quietness in his belly. He shall not save that which he desired. There shall none of his meat be left. Therefore shall no man look for his goods. Right, so it ain't gonna be no more trading in Merchant City, America. It ain't gonna be none of that, man. And the fullness of his sufficiency shall he be in straits. Every hand of the wicked shall come upon him. Right. And these nations gonna come upon him to destroy him. Jake and them gonna be fighting and going race wars and stuff gonna be happening all throughout America. It says, when he is about to fill his belly, the Most High shall cast the fury of his wrath upon him. And what it means by fill his belly is Esau gonna have it to a point where he almost, you know, at that point we're gonna implement that new world order. He already got the legislations, he already got the military already in all these nations, and already, you know, in America stationed everywhere. He already got the concentration camps set up, the guillotine set up, he already got the plagues and the diseases already kicking, you know. But when it comes time for him to put that icing on the cake, which is when you push out that chip and have everybody take that chip and get it like a clamp on everything, then the Lord gonna shoot nuclear missiles on him. It says, when he is about to fill his belly, the Most High shall cast the fury of his wrath upon him, and shall rain it upon him while he is eating. He shall flee from the iron weapon, and the bow of steel shall strike him through. And that's talking about the nuclear missiles, man. These nations gonna shoot nuclear missiles on America. Why? Because that's biblical prophecy. Well, I'm gonna jump to one more scripture. All right. Sorry, this is 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 8. But, beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away. And the heavens is talking about, America, a government, you know, certain people are in their heaven at this point in time. Like these white people, they're in their heaven. They get everything they want from any nation, and they can go anywhere they want. And, you know, and don't no nations mess with them. That's the part of them being in their heaven. It says, in which the heavens, which is America, shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. The earth also and the works that are therein shall be burnt up. Right, and that's talking about the nuclear missiles that's going to hit America, right?
Maybe he'll tell us something new.
No, they'll tell us what they want us to hear. Keep the panic at the low sweat stage.
I really don't think either side wants to be the first to use a nuclear device.
You know, it's not a question of who, but where. Over whose real estate. Say we explode a nuclear bomb over their troops on our side. The fallout had better not drift over to their side.
They're crazy. How do they expect it's going to stop with just one bomb?
You want to know what crazy is? Crazy's not staying out of other people's business. We shouldn't be over there in the first place.
Well, maybe they'll contain it. After all, I've still got symphony tickets for tonight.
The thing that bothers me is that damn Lantron warning.
What's that?
That's when one side tells the other that they're going to fire their missiles as soon as they think the other guy's missiles are already on the way.
You know, use them or lose them.
What do you really think the chances of something like that happening way the hell out here in the middle of nowhere?
Nowhere? There's no nowhere anymore. You're sitting next to the Whiteman Air Force Base right now. That's about 150 Minuteman missile silos spread halfway down the state of Missouri. That's an awful lot of bullseyes.
What's going on?
Those are Minuteman missiles.
Like a test, sort of. Like a warning?
They're on their way to Russia. They take about 30 minutes to reach their target.
So do theirs, right?